Hi, I'm Benjamin Berger, a professor at Osgoode Hall Law School. Let me tell you a little known story from Canadian legal history. The year was 1875, and a federal election was approaching in the county of Charlevoix, Quebec. The Liberal Party of the time was advancing a platform that would limit the rights and privileges of the Catholic Church in the affairs of public government. The bishops instructed the curés of the county to direct their parishioners not to vote for the Liberals. The clergy complied, and with soaring rhetoric. One priest declared that, and I quote, "Our bishop tells us that it is no longer permitted to be conscientiously a Catholic liberal. Be careful never to taste of the fruit of the tree, Catholic liberal." The Liberal candidate, Mr. Pierre-Alexis Tremblay, was soundly defeated, but his supporters challenged the election, claiming that the church had exerted undue influence on the election. He took the case to the Supreme Court of Canada, and the court agreed, annulling the election. Justice Ritchie found that the church's influence so permeated the county as to make it impossible to say that there was a free election. He explained that this was not at all a religious question. It was simply a constitutional legal question. The facts of this case are interesting and specific to their time, but the basic question that the case raises is one that has been with us for hundreds of years and is very much still with us today. What is the just and appropriate relationship among religion, law, and public life? This question is at the core of my research on law and religion. It's a question that raises basic issues of diversity and equality, of constitutional law, of history and philosophy, and of the central role of law in governing our collective lives. Today we're facing a host of difficult issues that flow from this basic question. Can a mature minor refuse a blood transfusion on religious grounds? Should polygamy be criminal? Can a religious community be exempt from general laws because of their religious beliefs? Can religious views form a part of public decision-making? The answers are elusive, but the questions can't be ignored.